Ahead of time. Again, welcome to everybody here over our Ustream YouTube network. We bring everything into the willingness of the Lord. And though we did just have a 4 minute breakdown in our other network, let's just get back into where we are. We're at Proverbs 17, 18 through 26. So again, let's go over this again. It doesn't hurt. A man void of understanding striketh hands and becometh surety in the presence of his friends. He loveth transgression that loveth strife, and he that exalteth his gate seeketh destruction. He that hath a forward heart findeth no good, and he that hath a perverse tongue falleth into mischief. He that begetteth a fool doth it to his sorrow, and the father of a fool hath no joy. A merry heart doth good like a medicine, but a broken spirit drieth the bones. A wicked man taketh a gift out of the bosom to pervert the ways of judgment. Wisdom is before him that hath understanding, but the eyes of a fool are in the ends of the earth. A foolish son is a grief to his father, and bitterness to her that bear him. Also to punish the just is not good, nor to strike princes for equity. So God brings us to that change. So 17, 18 expresses to all of us as we break this down for you. A man void of understanding striketh hands and becometh surety in the presence of his friends. Let not any wrong their families. Yet Christ becoming surety for men was a glorious display of divine wisdom, for he was able to discharge their bond. Proverbs 17:19. He that loveth transgression, that loveth strife, and he that exalteth his gate, seeketh destruction. It's very important to keep your mind clear at all times. Ask God for everything. If you have not, because you ask not. If we would keep a clear conscience and a quiet mind, we must shun all excitements to anger. And a man who affects his style of living above his means goes the way to ruin. Now, I've always said that going for witnessing and teaching to our homeless brethren, live above your circumstances. But when you've got yourself established, your own apartment, your job, your money's coming in, doesn't mean though you have to compete against other people. Some young ministers try to compete against the larger ministries, try to show off the lifestyle. You know, your lifestyle, brothers and sisters, is how you adopt, and live for Jesus Christ. That's your lifestyle. That's my lifestyle. I do not have a great lifestyle of the rich and famous, but I am known throughout all the world, so is my wife. And we are growing ministry, prosperous ministry. All of our needs are being met. And one time our needs did have needs. But we go forward. Not living and spending above our means, but going forward and just not allowing Satan any measure to come into our lives and to destroy this marriage, this unity, this ministry. This comes into, okay, the clarity of the mind, the weapons of warfare. They may come, but they shall not destroy us. In verse 20, God expresses his utmost wisdom all the time for us. We just have to receive it. We just have to receive it. He that hath a forward heart findeth no good, and he that hath a perverse tongue falleth into mischief. There is nothing got by ill designs, and many have paid dear for unbridled tongue. Unbridled tongue. We go into God's embrace for change. We want change in our lives. We're bringing this forward. Proverbs 17, verse 21. God brings to us his knowledge at all times. He that begetteth a fool doth it to his sorrow, and the father of a fool hath no joy. This speaks right to the point, doesn't it? Very plainly. What many wise and good men feel very strongly, but how grievous it is to have a foolish and wicked child. We go into, God wants to bring you into his life. He wants to bring you to the natural, to the supernatural. He wants to bring you to his embrace. He wants to bring you to that time frame of the now of faith. Bring us, O Lord, to your time. Bring us, O Lord, to your absolute wisdom of truth. Bring us, O Lord, to the measurement of having us crucify ourselves daily before the cross every day. So we have that strength in this going forward every day. We have that strength going into unity, the Holy Spirit, every day. God brings us to that understanding. God brings us to the measurement, connecting with us for the now. The beautiful truth, the now. The loving part of it, the now. Coming into that expression. We live in such a world that the world is calling for that change to be with you. The world is calling for you to come into his presence. Let's go before the presence of God and express that change. Let's go before the throne of God and ask God anything that is upon our hearts. Let us ask, seek, and knock. Let us open up our hearts. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Forever and ever, brothers and sisters. This is coming at a time when the world is going through chaos. The world is going through so much that the expressions of the Lord need to be united and expressed and spread throughout the world, one country at a time. My wife and I have already been to Kenya, other countries. We're going back again. We're going to Tanzania, Cape Town, South Africa. We're going. Niger, Nigeria, England. And we're going also, brothers and sisters, we hope to have you join us in our continued work in Canada and, of course, here in Los Angeles. This, we cannot do this alone. And your new life with Christ starts with a new relationships, a new relationship with Christ, coming into the purity of that new heart that God gave you, coming forward into the renewing of your time frame, right now, the now of faith, the now of your new life, right now. And this comes at this time when you need to have those new relationships. We encourage you to get into faith-based Bible-believing church, midweek Bible study, Sunday services, fellowship with the saints, fall small group Bible studies. You got your Bible study, you got your preaching and teaching right here when you need it. 6 a.m. we start here, 11 a.m. my wife kicks in at 11 a.m. and 3 p.m. I come back at 6 p.m. All times are Pacific Standard Time. And if you live in a part of the world that you're not too sure what that is, just look at the United States, the North, West Coast of North America, and here we are today with you live over Ustream, YouTube, and coming before us right now. Going over the breakdown, now going into verse 22. In the instrument of the truthful measures that God gives us, he gives us a heart, the new heart. That's for Proverbs 22, verse 17, Proverbs 17, verse 22. A merry heart doth good like a medicine, but a broken spirit drieth the bones. So it is important for us to see God's love, his unity, his expression right now. There is nothing at all proper or God does not want you to breathe spend your life with the wicked, for the wicked are ready to part with their money, though loved, that they may not suffer for their crimes. So the rich and famous may get away with murder, but they can't get away with murder with God. Okay? They can fool the ways of man, but they can't fool God. They can fool you, but they can't fool God. They can attempt to fool my wife and I, but they can't fool God. And there's so many ill people out there, brothers and sisters. You don't need to be part of their game. You don't need to be the instruments of their pathetic lifestyle. Coming into this, brothers and sisters, we express how this all began. Not so much in Wisdom 17, Proverbs 17, the expressions of wisdom, how it all began for not just Anita and myself, but let's say a pastor that you know in your community, how it began with him, how it began with your neighbor that you know who's been saved for many years, and how this comes. It's first, God showed us this cup of wisdom in the actuality. It's a cup of tea my wife gave me. In a few moments, it'll be done and gone. But God laid out for you a treasure chest full of rubies and anointing ornaments for you to live and use for all of eternity. They are all expressed through hope, faith, and love, but your key of wisdom is what's going to unlock that treasure chest. It can only happen when you are redeemed with Christ, when you turn yourself over to God. So many, many, many decades ago, in separate parts of the world, Anita and the man, yours truly here, took one step forward. When we turned our lives over to the Lord, that was our introduction for us of getting married so many, many, many years later. Romans 10:13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Let's repeat this after me. Dear God, I admit I am a sinner. I need your forgiveness. I believe that Jesus Christ died in my place, paying the penalty for my sins. I am willing right now to turn from my sin and accept Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior. I commit myself to you and ask you to send the Holy Spirit into my life and to fill and take control and to help me become the kind of person you have always wanted me to be. Thank you, Father, for bringing me forward. Thank you, Father, for making this change. Thank you, Jesus. That's my wife singing your name. I am praising your name. And most important, the angels are praising your name before the throne of God as we're speaking. As we're speaking. Brothers and sisters, this is your time frame. Your love. Your embrace for the matchless name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. And also, brothers and sisters, your first offering is the offering of obedience, getting into the living word of God, getting into that time frame, his love, his purity, getting into that time of expressing the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, one Father, and all. We are preaching here the living word of God. Very simple. Receive the instructions of God. Receive his time. Receive the all and all that God wants you to have. Brothers and sisters, you will change the world. You will change the world in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one mind and one judgment of Christ. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Going further with a continuing breakdown. Wisdom is before him that hath understanding, but the eyes of a fool are in the ends of the earth. That's 24. The prudent man keeps the word of God continually in view, but the foolish man cannot fix his thoughts nor pursue any purpose with steadiness. So they volunteer to go over their own stumbling blocks. They don't walk through the stumbling blocks, hopefully like you do. They attempt to walk around them, or they just stand still, thinking that the stumbling blocks are going to be removed. And the longer they stay there, the deeper their you-know-what grows upon that stumbling block. And they become the stench of that stumbling block, an abomination to the Lord, because they're allowing themselves to be controlled. There is the measurement of the oppressors to those being oppressed. But there comes a time when those who are being oppressed must realize that, hey, something's not right here. And God gives you opportunity after opportunity to pray for you, to pray for God, to come and receive him at your life-changing experience, to just shout out Jesus and have that stumbling block removed. Faith cometh by hearing by the word of God. And we go into the spirit of the now of faith. We go into that expression right now. In Proverbs 17, verse 25, God's expression expresses to us, a foolish son is grief to his father and bitterness that bear him. Also to punish the just is not good, nor to strike princes for equity. The breakdown expresses to all of us here, brethren, wicked children despise the authority of the father and the tenderness of their mother. It is very wrong to find fault for doing what is duty. What, so you're saying to all of us today, yourself, what do we want? We make choices according to our heart. A scripture reference would be Proverbs 16:23 and Exodus chapter 35, verse 5, 21, 26, 29. We can choose to set our heart's affections. Total depravity is not the lack of death of intellectual ability, but rather the loss of death of the affection and desires toward God. Righteousness and his word will change us. The living word of God. A pure heart has undivided affection at the highest level of fervency for God, righteousness, and his word. The Lord sees all that is in our hearts, so we cannot hide. And there's several with scriptures here, so let's just give you a handful. Hebrews chapter 4, 12 through 14, Revelation chapter 2, verse 23, and Jeremiah 17, verse 10. If we regard iniquity in our heart, then we understand we allow sin in our hearts that is unconfessed. He will not hear any of our prayers if we have unconfessed sin in our hearts. Our Lord condemns hearing, believing, and or talking as inadequate. We must love God in all of our hearts and bear fruitful works by his love. So our faith that we have, we back that up by our fruitful works by his love. Vain religion is thinking you are doing fine without being part of his fruit. Great men recognize a priceless asset and fruit as providing great, great goodness. Proverbs 22, verse 11. The Proverbs fully express God's love through the instrument of wisdom. Pureness of heart and the love of it leads to gracious speech. We can judge the hearts of others by their words and actions easily. Great men despise those with a perverse heart. Those with evil eyes and hearts are to be avoided. The wise man asks his son for his heart, and this is the key to his salvation. God is asking you for that old heart of yours to give you a new heart. God is asking you to make that sacrifice of walking away from your sinful life, the yoke of bondage, to that new life. The Lord will be strong for them whose heart is perfect toward him. The most glorious woman in God's sight, and those with hidden pure hearts, the Holy Ghost blessed the early church with a collective pure heart, and God judges those with idols. Those with idols in their heart who choose stumbling blocks, as we just mentioned. Ezekiel chapter 14, chapter 3 and 4, and verse 7. A merry heart can change your life. Trust me, there's nothing wrong with being happy. There's nothing wrong with going out with friends, but if you keep on going back to the same old happy hour stench bar with everyone just doing their own pity party and two-for-one specials with this pity party, just stay where you are. You know, Satan will begin your year thinking you're on the straight and narrow. That that straight and narrow actually becomes one long circle, and you end up in the same place you started the year as you end your year. But we're not going to do that, are we? Drawing nigh to God requires a true heart and full assurance of faith. We can't do this part-time. We can't do this half-butted. We can't do this without committing ourselves. And because it takes a commitment to follow Christ. God wants all of you. Advancement in general is a reflection of the heart. So we go forward. You should have no care for what anyone says or does unto you. I've had several attempts in my life. Everyone backed up and protected by the love of Jesus Christ. I've had several people try to poison my food, backed up by the love of Jesus. I've had several people, go out and out of the way to try to harm me, but I'm backed up by the love of God. God has brought me to your home, your computer, your living room, your TV set to bring change to your life. I am not the one to thank. I am not the one to worship, but it is God to give thanks. I am his humble relationship, his vehicle on this earth, one of many vehicles. I hope you join my wife and I as being vehicles. And these vehicles are brand new vehicles. There's no used car party here. God gives you a new heart. He renews your mind. He renews your strength of your body. He renews how you walk, how you talk, how you see the world, from the natural to the supernatural. Once you're in that supernatural vision, you've seen what you once were. And you just can't believe what you once were. Bring to us, O God, the application of that new life. Bring to us, O God, the instrument of your loving support. Bring us, O God, to the realities that you've expressed to us, one mind, one judgment of Christ, to come into that message of now. Now, myself, I have a creative background, been on my own for early ages, moved around, grew around, beautiful daughter that I have, and all of us see each other grow. My daughter is one of the few people that have saw the finger of God work in me. Others stayed in their blindness, wanted to stay in their old ways of sin, didn't want to hear about this God thing, this Jesus thing, this, and possibly will go to church on Christmas and Easter because my mom or my relatives will give me a bigger present. No, that's nonsense. God gave you a bigger present when he died for you on the cross. He forgave you of your sins. Then he showed you that empty tomb, which is the depth of that new heart of yours. God is bringing you into that moment right now to bring into the everlasting reality of your love. God brings to you his truthfulness. God brings to you his expression of his love. For in the matchless name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, amen. This time is your time. This time is going to bring you to that reality that God has always wanted you to have, and that is you and God alone. Mark 11:22, have faith in God. Have faith in God. Mark 11:23, verse 26, I'm not going to express it to you, but you should know it by now. Go into it, use that verse as your personal prayer time with God, one-on-one alone. Forgive those of their sins. Forgive those. Then believe in your heart what you are asking for God, and you shall receive it. But forgiveness must come first. Love them. The persecute you, despise them, but doesn't mean you have to hang with them or hug them. Just forgive them and love them, and have the Lord Jesus embrace them if and when they come forward in the name of Jesus. And how you get back to your enemies is not by so much taking their heads off, but by forgiving them. And I can give you a whole testimony of that. God's forgiveness, God's love, God's truth, and I shall give that to you someday. God's embrace gives you that supernatural lifestyle. In Jesus' name, let's go before the throne of God and pray. Dear Jesus, we thank you for your love. We thank you for your time that brings us to the strength of your unity, of your vision, bringing us to the unity of the holy strength, one God, one love, one truth. We bring you to this everlasting joy, O Lord. We bring joy to the world. We bring joy to as change makers, as peacemakers. We go forward throughout all the countries you have mentioned to us. We ask all to come into this life, our world, and to express change for all. In the matchless name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, we love you. And again, brothers and sisters, that does conclude our broadcast for this morning. Come and visit us at BryantHewitt.com. Keep up to date on all of our information, and we invite you to become a financial partner with us. If you don't want to click on the donation link on our website, our contact information is in the bottom left corner. You can send us a check. MCM Ministries is you can write the check out to. Our full name is Morningstar Communications Network. We are a 501c3 certified church here in the United States. So we walk by faith and not by sight. On behalf of Anita Hewitt and yours truly, the man Bryant, again, we thank you for your time. Until next time, au revoir, adios, good day for the people.